international clash over 6 5-minute rounds. Two goals, two submissions, or a knockout to decide. In the red corner, just arrived in this country, that martial arts sensation. Will you give a really big welcome to Sammy? In the blue corner, the tough guy from Leeds, welcome, Cyanide Sid Cooper.
So here we go again with the first appearance of another man in this country, Sammy Lee from Tokyo, Japan. In the welterweight bracket, though it's very difficult to get his weight from him, he doesn't speak too much English. About 11 stone 9 is my translation. Just about the same as Sid Cooper, his opponent, Sid Cooper from Bradford. 6 5-minute rounds, two falls to the side. This is, of course, a great martial arts expert. In fact, he even looks a little like Bruce Lee from a distance there. How about that? Not too far off the style of movement, the way he got in the ring. I don't think you'll be allowed to use that in this country. And here we go for round one. Without the stick, Sid Cooper will be delighted to hear. Oh yes, this is Bruce Lee all over this one. Look at that back heel kick. I don't think Cooper's going to get anywhere near it. Lee grabbed his leg there, beautiful. And he let Cooper grab his on purpose. Oh yes, what a fall, cross press. Straight down for a count of three, I would guess. Yes, no problem. Well, in 39 seconds of round one, Cooper bites the dust for the first fall. Goes to Lee. Oh, I've never seen anything like that. That was really cool.
Ladies and gentlemen, in round one, the first ball goes to Sammy Lee.
Cooper starting down at me there, makes you laugh at me, but the point is that it really was a funny one. Lee now doing a few splits exercises in his corner. But, and I'm sure Sid Cooper won't like to hear this, there are another 5 rounds to go yet. Let's see what happens in round two.
Round two.
Let's hope Sid can come in there just a little bit closer and get some wrestling hold on to stop this onslaught here. This fellow was trained by the famous Carl Gotch from Odessa, Florida, and that's where he actually lives now, or just coming out of there to this country. I don't know how long he's been there, because his English is not too good. Do a reverse drop kick all right there. Sid Cooper being very much more careful now. And that's what happens when you try and when you try a headmare this man. So up comes that leg so quickly. Oh yeah, yeah, this is the fastest mover I think we've seen in the professional ring in this country for a long time. Cooper will have to think of something special now. Like getting out of the ring, I think. Yes. And lever. In the wrist of the elbow, holding it against the joint nicely. And what can he get from it? Trying to make a backhammer from it? He's got no chance. Well, he can wrestle too. It was a beautiful move. Beautiful counter to that arm lever by Sammy Lee. And the punch going in the back. This is what Cooper, of course, must resort to. This is typical of Sid Cooper. When he's in trouble, out comes the punch. Pretending it's the blood of the hand. Well, we can see that just as well at home there as we can at this side. Oh, beautiful back somersault, getting the toe under the chin on the way. And the back over the head. Sammy Lee is going to cause a lot of wrestlers a lot of trouble over here. Get a look at those thighs of Sammy Lee, the power of those thighs in soccer players. Tremendous power. Reverse double knee hold. Now, can you hold it? No. Pulling the hair. Crotch hold and slam. Reverse double knee again. And the punch just to hold him down. The referee spotted that punch. Still got the hair. Sammy Lee doesn't like that. I think if I was Sid Cooper, I think I'd a hasty retreat as well. It's 2 minutes to go if it lasts that long in round two. Nice heel kick, so it's coming from any angle. Nicely, that's good.
Ask him. No.
Ask him. This man, Sammy Lee, is going to submit from that. 90 seconds he's got, and whether Sammy Lee can beat the bell here out of this, I don't think there's any doubt at all. In fact, he doesn't need more than about 9 of the 90. Paul Nelson, Cooper. Even gets the foot to the back of Cooper, or from a Paul Nelson position. I bet Cooper's never got one of those before. I certainly have never seen that one. Just a minute left. Round two. One fall down, Cooper, going for the grapevine. Opposite arm lever. Now, could this have the Japanese boy in trouble? Punch to the small of the back. Posting, yes, not like that too much. Cooper doing better now, as long as he keeps it legal. Reverse double knee up from the knee to his forehead. Half a minute left. Well, he gets up that bridge. Ooh, yeah, tremendous power. Double arm now to Lee. The way that foot's placed alongside the shoulder, in between the shoulder blades there. Just 7 seconds, he's going to last. 5, 4, 3, 2, he's made it. But Cooper, not happy about the bell at all. He wants to continue now while he thinks he's got the advantage. Well, how he thinks he's got the advantage, I don't know. Public warning anyway for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of round two, the referee gives Cyanide Sid Cooper a public warning.
Well, if he must be so stupid as to continue in the interval, what does he expect?
Certainly, round three.
Round three. One public warning against Cooper, but one fall also against Cooper. Four rounds to go. Now, backbreaker attacks. I don't think this man is going to back this breakable, if you see what I mean. It's just so subtle. Subtle, I mean. And every move is so subtle. Punches again. He's had enough of that. Oh, that shot came straight up. And the drop kick went over the side of the head rather than the top. Well, he aimed for, but it worked. The heel caught. He's never been out of the ring so fast as that before, Sid Cooper. Let's call him Cyanide Sid, though. A punt that he doesn't even start to make. He's not even going to make a 30-second punt. A knockout, therefore, to Lee in 1 minute, 7 seconds of round three.
Sammy Lee. And gentlemen, after 1:07 of round three, the winner on the knockout, Sammy Lee. And your appreciation for the loser, Cyanide Sid Cooper.